Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we are going to create a cover design using Fotor Application. The design includes some vector shapes. We'll work with color panel and layer option to adjust the vectors. We'll also look at how to change the background image inside the design. So let's begin with a new document. Open the Fotor interface. Click on new dimension and this will open up the template page. Here, you'll find all the necessary project dimensions. For this design, let's choose one of the options. Select Google Plus Cover. Under this, you'll find a collection of design templates. You can directly select and use one of them.
You can directly use them and change the font here. Here also, you can even select this and like zoom the image, like whichever you way. Cancel it. You can rotate the image as well. So if you want to flip it like this, you can flip it and use it according to your requirement. You can even give nice effect to the images like this. So these are all the options available. So let me show you what we can do while creating this design. So let's work on a new dimension. Let's choose custom 2000 by 1100, apply. And here is a new document here. Let's change the background to light blue color. So let's select the background and apply blue color. Then increase the brightness like this to give a light blue tone to the background like that. Now next thing is we'll add these vector shapes. So we'll go to sticker and let's find some vector shapes related to our design. So I need some plants. So PLANTS plants. Let's tap out and enter. And we got a few collections of vector shapes. So let me choose some of it. Let's say I want to use this. Okay, it's there. I'll place it around here. Let me collect a few more. I'll select this. Okay, two. I need a leaf. So let me type leaves here. LEAVES leaves, and let's see what do we get. So you got this shape. Let me put it in. Let's place it around here. Okay, we got a different one as well. So this, and we need a big leaf. So let me find some leaves. Choose a leaf from here. Let's see. Like this. Okay, we got this. Select this one and this. Now let's do the proper placement. So first of all, let me show you how to change the color of your vectors. So simply select them and we got these all the color options. Just select and make it darker. Let's choose a blue color from here. Maybe a little bluish and greenish tone and make it darker. Little bit darker like that. Select the other one and apply the same. Select the other one and apply the same. So here it is. You can adjust the color tone using this. And after that, we'll select it and apply the same color. So let's do the proper placement. I'll rotate it and increase the size. Let's zoom it out and place it around here. Okay, next I'll select this one, rotate it and increase the size. So our work area is almost filled up with the leaves. Let me do some color adjustments. So first of all, let's create that rectangular shape. So let's add that using the sticker here. Basic shape. So I'll just get back to and select the basic shapes here. Select the rectangle and increase the size with the Alt and Shift pressed, and with the Alt and Shift pressed increases the width area equally like that. And now place it around here. Now let's give a white color. So select the color from here, from the color swatches here, color panel, and choose white color. And after that, let's do some adjustments with the layer. So we need this layer on top. So go to layer and move to top. In the same way, select this one and layer, move to top. If you need to do some color correction, let's do that. So I'll just go and select like bluish tone like that for this one. Select them and choose the same color like that for all the three color boxes. Nice one. This one is on the back. Okay, so after that we'll add some text. So in the same way, select the text tool and select this, click on that and it will be there. Here, place it around here, select the text, type out in a small text, so SEAC SID side. And for this, let's choose a different font, like let's see which font is suitable for this. Let's choose this one. And this is this font, this is Grand Hotel font. So let's increase the size to Alt and Shift press and place it around here. Give it a dark blue color. So choose a color from here and pick the color and increase the darkness using the slider. And after that, select this rectangle, create a duplicate, scale down the size, give it a color, let's say yellow. Okay, and let's adjust the size with a shift and alt press. I'll increase the width area and reduce the height and place it below it. Now I create a duplicate of the text and place it on top, scale down the size, type out cover, and let's choose a different font for this. So I'll choose like, let's say this one. Maybe that's, we are just trying out with a different font. So I think this is good. Let's reduce the size a little bit and place it in the center. Reduce the width of the rectangle as well. And let's change the color. So let's change it to white color. Choose a color from the this color panel. And let's give a little gap between each alphabet to give a like a broader feel as well. And we'll add a little text on top as well. So I create a duplicate of this text one more time and place it on top. Decrease the size with the Alt and Shift pressed. And let's type out GRAPHIC graphic design. Increase the width area and choose a proper font for this. So let's choose our previous font, Antonio. That's a really good font. And let's reduce the size and increase the width area. So spacing, that's the spacing between each alphabet. And let's give it a yellow color, the same color which we have used here. So with using the eyedropper tool, I'm picking the color and it's applied very easily. Now let's do some adjustments. So our third design is also ready. You can just keep on adjusting, or you can use a different vector shape for this and it's ready. So I'll just save it. So go to save and choose PNG or maybe JPEG and put select the highest quality and then download it. Now we look at how to add an image inside your design, and it's very simple. You just have to import an image. So select the image from your library, any image for your background, and open it here. And it will be imported. After importing your image, you just click on the thumbnail and it will be placed on your work area. Let's increase the size, like with the shift and alt press, just increase up the size. And after that, and move step by step downward like this. Move up, up, and let's see. So here is our design. We have placed photo image inside our vector image. It was very simple. And let's change the color of the vectors according to our design. So selected and using the eyedropper tool, let's pick a color from our design. In the same way, I'll select this and pick a color from here using the eyedropper. Let's choose maybe a little darker tone or faded one and apply it. For this also, let me change a few stuff. So I'll make it a little darker. Let's change the color of this as well. So pick a dark color from the image matching the design, and let me change the background color as well. So select individual shapes, so select and pick a color from here. So select it and apply a nice faded color from there like that. And after that, select the text and apply the same color. And we got an interesting cover here. So first one was completely vector, and this second one, using the same elements, we have got an interesting design which includes a photo as well. And just selecting that, we can just go around with different effects here, like the same options which we have seen in the templates image as well. So selecting this, you can give different color tones. I think the original is looking great, and you can even flip it horizontally or vertically as per your requirements. So until now, we have seen all the features or all the tools which we need to create a vector design. Next, we're going to edit an image using the footer in the next video and look at more other features about this application. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out the next video coming up. Thank you.